Ministries presents The Testimony of Jesus.
My name is Lazarus. Feels good to be alive. When I in chains of death was bound, this man named Jesus.
1 Peter 2:24. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, that we might die to sin and live unto righteousness. For by his stripes you were healed.
Living testimony of his death-defying touch. My name is Lazarus.
Join us as we witness this same Jesus as he transforms and restores lives today. Experience real passion for Jesus Christ.
Welcome to Healing Rooms Ministries, where the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. I'm Cal Pierce, Director of Healing Rooms Ministries, and we'd like to welcome you to the program today. And I have today as co-host with me Elaine Perkins. And Elaine is an associate director, and you work in the International Association of Healing Rooms.
Yes, I do.
And you connect with all the regional and national directors, and she does a very good job at that. And we have Elaine as co-host because her and I have a guest, which we'll call a special guest, Linda Keough. And John and Linda, actually, you know, you're in Hawaii now, but God moved you from this area to Hawaii, and you kind of got your feet wet in the healer rooms when we first started.
Oh, absolutely.
I'll never forget that day of redigging the well.
Amen.
It was May 29. Mm-hmm. 1999, where we were in the location where the healing rooms were in the Rookery building downtown, hadn't even started the ministry. We were just all praying, and I remember you and John were there that day, and I don't think we realized the history that was being made on that day. There was, I don't know, 120
people
there.
You know, John and I share a lot about divine connections, and absolutely, you coming into our life and Elaine, it was just absolutely a divine connection because we had been ordained. We heard about John G. Lake in the beginning of the 90s and were ordained through John G. Lake's ministry in 1992, so we started, but at that time it's like, who is John G. Lake? Yeah. So I started looking back at John G. Lake and some of the old, you know, Mariah Woodworth Eder and those ones that had been before us, and this thing just started to stir in me. Well, we were in Seattle. Now, we lived in Coeur d'Alene at the time, and we were in Seattle at a minister's meeting, and somebody said, or it was Joe McIntyre, the president of John G. Lake's ministry. He said, we're going to be in your neck of the woods next week. And there's a man named Cal Pierce who's going to open up those healing rooms again that John G. Lake had. And I'm like, no way, we're there. Now, the interesting thing was, we lived right across in Idaho at the time, and you're here in Spokane, and we never heard anything about you or the healing rooms. And so that was an absolute divine connection coming from Seattle.
Yes.
And then, and that was in 1999, because the rooms opened up July 22nd, 1999. Yes. In 1997, we had a church over in Coeur d'Alene, and we would travel back and forth to Hawaii, and God spoke marching orders to me. And while we were at a family camp meeting during worship, I'm kind of standing against the wall, and the Lord said, you will be a pillar in the islands. And I'm like, what does that mean? Uh-huh. You know, sometimes when we hear words from the Lord, we get a piece here and a piece there, and then it takes a while sometimes for those pieces to come together.
Yes. Right?
And here was 1997, and then 1999 when we met you, and I had a prayer group going for like 3 years, and after the digging of the wells, I stopped by the healing rooms to come see you, and it was just simple. You know, you still had the little like old military chairs and desk, and you said, we're looking for intercessors, and I'm like, I'm there. You know, there's times in our lives where you know that something is a God thing and a God moment.
Yeah.
And there's divine connections and divine linkings, and I knew it. It's like we just dropped everything and said, this is a God thing.
Mm-hmm. So you started out in the healing rooms in Spokane in that birthing of the work, and then God fulfilled that vision, and
Yeah.
I remember when we went on a conference, I don't know if you were there, Elaine, mm-hmm. when we dropped you guys off at the airport.
Yeah. Yes,
you
know, that was so much fun.
Oh, we're all crying, you know, and oh, they're leaving because you were going to Hawaii to move there and begin to establish Healing Rooms.
Just, mm-hmm. you know, the thing I wanted to share after meeting you, John had gone to Hawaii and was praying and fasting for 3 days seeking the Lord. Mm-hmm. And I was praying here and things were just getting started, you know, just mm-hmm. that birthing of it. And I just want to put a plug in. If anybody hasn't read Preparing the Way by Cal Pierce, it's excellent. It's really a good book. It talks about the things we're talking about right now in the beginning. Mm-hmm. Yes. And so when I was praying, all of a sudden I had a vision of the map of the United States and the pillar popped up out of Florida. A pillar started to pop up out of the central USA, California, Oregon, Washington, and I knew they were Healing Rooms. Uh-huh. And at that moment I said, Lord, is that what you meant? That we'd be a pillar in Hawaii? The Healing Rooms? Yes. And at the same moment in Hawaii, God was talking to John saying, we'll have a Healing Room in Hawaii. And then here John G. Lake had that vision in Oregon from the angel with that reef for China, Honolulu, San Francisco.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And here, being part of the first mm-hmm. beginnings mm-hmm. to take that trip to Oregon and then have you guys bless us in Portland, where John G. Lake also left Spokane and went mm-hmm. and opened up those rooms.
Yeah.
I'm like, wow. And you'd always be saying, we're making history.
Yes.
We're being history makers. Yeah. And
you know, every healing room is important. Mm-hmm. But I think it's interesting that you heard from the Lord that you were going to be a pillar, because now, as it turns out, John and Linda are our regional directors over all the islands.
Yeah.
And so to me it's like you're a pillar in the leadership as well. Mm-hmm. So that's really exciting.
Because how long were we opened before that happened? It wasn't long.
No. I mean, like, we already knew. We said, Cal, we know we're supposed to go to Hawaii, but we had to meet you before we could even go.
Yeah. Well, and then we started, people started inviting us out to come and share our testimony and cast a vision for Healing Rooms, you know. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I remember when we dropped you guys off and, you know, we got over, you know, the fact that, we're all crying and everything. And going home, and we thought, well, you know, if we're supposed to be doing conferences and we just sent somebody to Hawaii, that's a great place to do a conference.
Yes, and we've done a few of them. They've been so wonderful.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely.
Worship island style and hula and dance, and Cal just really spoken into the nation, into the people mm-hmm. as a father, and mm-hmm. Elaine's got to come, and we just always have so much fun. We're getting ready to do a conference again in Hawaii, Oahu, the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd of March. And even as we're speaking, Maui's called up and wanted to do a healing room. So there's a Honolulu Healing Rooms right in the heart of the nation. If anybody doesn't know, the islands of Hawaii, Oahu is the state capital. That's where the government all is.
Yes.
And the palace where the king and queen used to live. And so the healing rooms actually used to look right over the palace where we could pray for the heart of the nation.
Mm-hmm.
And now there's a healing room in Waianae, which is a very poor, like if you're looking at the airport of Oahu, it's this end of the island. It's a lot of Hawaiian people, Samoan people, a lot of people living in tents right now.
Uh-huh.
But God is moving. There's a coalition of like 40, 50 pastors who are out there. They're going to build homes and stuff for the homeless. Well, we have a healing room out there now.
Oh, that's
and
good.
So the healing rooms has favor with all that side of the island. There's a Kim and our Tim.
Kim and Kevin. Hill.
The hills in the Big Island and Hilo. And God just blessed them with a church building.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, things are just happening. Maui just called and they're wanting to start a healing room. So.
See, but you went in directed by God and you were obedient and you plowed.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, you didn't go over there and
tossed in the middle of an island.
You know, it takes some time.
Yes,
you know,
it does.
And
it does.
When you have that vision and you move towards it,
mm-hmm.
you know, the Lord gives you a breaker anointing.
Right,
you know,
absolutely.
Even though plowing isn't easy because you're having to rip up some hard ground,
mm-hmm.
and that's work.
Oh, mm-hmm. yeah.
But when the ground's ripped up, then the seed goes in,
right.
and then harvest starts. And, you know, and you guys are starting to experience that in the islands, and it's coming very powerfully.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And it's your destiny. You know, it's been hard ground, but it's not been something that's been overwhelming where you've wanted to leave because you knew you were right in the middle of mm-hmm. your destiny, mm-hmm. right?
Yes. And, you know, it's interesting, too, talking of that, even some of the team members, they're like, well, you can't give up. You're part of our destiny.
Right.
Yes,
see,
that's right.
And I remember, I'm like, wow, we don't think of that,
yeah.
that we're part of your
yes.
destiny. Mm-hmm. We're all part of each other.
It's your family.
And I remember praying one time in Hawaii and just like you said, trying to birth the things and mm-hmm. praying and, you know, not even really knowing. But I remember seeing a great big forest. And as I was praying, I had this sword in my hand and you're chopping through the forest. And the next thing you know, there's a path made. So that still ahead of us, it looks like a forest, but at least people who are coming behind,
behind.
Now have a pathway to walk
right.
down.
Yes, yeah.
right.
absolutely.
And
yeah.
and so one of our people we've asked to be our directors, they're praying about it right now. She was asking me all these questions about, you know, what, and we're driving down the road, and I said, you know when you pioneer, we really just are going straight ahead, but I really can't give you a whole lot of answers. We're going for the ride.
Sure.
And one of the things that I so appreciate, Cal, about what you said, the Healing Room Ministry, everything's already been established and set. As you said, the vehicle's there. We just need drivers to get in there.
That's right.
And to take
yes.
that position and then just start heading down the
yes.
pathway.
Right.
Yeah.
You know?
And it's there available for people groups
Everyone, yeah.
all over the world,
right.
no matter whether they're mm-hmm. Samoan, not Samoan, Hawaiian, Chinese, every
exactly.
people group. Jesus
exactly.
wants yeah. to heal the body all over the world.
That's
We're
right.
all part of that body.
That's
and,
right.
and to see all of those people groups and backgrounds coming together,
mm-hmm.
working together in
mm-hmm.
a healing room is very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I like to think of the healing rooms as a river work. You know, because
mm-hmm.
I mean, mm-hmm. you go to their healing rooms and the river's flowing.
Amen.
You know, I mean,
yeah, it is.
You might be standing up when you get
God.
When the prayer starts, but you may be laying on the floor when it ends. You know, you just never
That's
know
right.
what God's going to do.
Well,
That's
you know,
right.
I was thinking how people. This was like so God in Spokane. This healing room ministry. To me, I look at it like a honeycomb, and the bees and the laborers just start coming to the honey from all over the nations. People started coming right from the beginning.
Yes.
And Elaine and I remember the first time we're in there praying, and we were pastored and we had gone to the nations and we'd ministered and we'd done a lot of things, but there was something different about
mm-hmm.
stepping into a healing
mm-hmm.
room and starting to pray, and all of us, our knees
yeah.
were knocking.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
We're kind of acting like we know what we're doing, but we just
but
really
we
don't know what we're
yeah.
doing.
Yeah.
And so we encourage people with that. You know,
mm-hmm.
just watch. It's okay. Just like you said,
yeah.
jump in. And the Holy Spirit just takes over. In Hawaii, you see that I have a lay on. And one of the Hawaiian gals, it was so neat. And she says, oh, I just felt so inferior to everybody else that was there. But the Lord had spoke to her and said, keep your love and devotion simple
mm-hmm.
before
yes.
me.
Yeah.
You know, and it's all about His presence. And without it, we are nothing and we have nothing.
Yes.
But here we... You know, to those who've been in a healing room, know there's the ministry team, and where God's word says we're two or more gathered together, and whatever we ask, He will do. Well, she said, so here's a person coming and praying and ministering, and another one. And she said, what the Lord showed her was like a flower lay, like each special prayer and each word and each person was building a lay that mm-hmm. was being placed upon the person. As
yes.
they were visiting the healing rooms, and
yeah.
it was the love of God, the aloha. And really, when you think about the team ministry in each life, even as this, how we all link together and working together, this
mm-hmm.
yes.
seeds, and how many seeds? Man, it's
yeah.
just, we haven't
oh,
even
yes.
seen anything yet, because
no.
seeds have been planted, but there's so many still planted, we haven't started to even see the harvest of it.
Right.
And speaking of that, I wanted to share a word.
Amen.
The Lord gave me a word
okay.
for you, Northwest.
Ah, good.
And so since we lived here for 20 years and we know it's like home, the power of intercession and the prayers that come forth in this region of the world is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
So the Lord said, don't give up, don't give up, don't give up. Arise and shine, my beloved. Arise above all your circumstances, for I've called you and I've seated you in heavenly places. There is no demonic power or force or principality that's going to stop or hinder or block the kingdom work, because we're seated above it in the heavenly places, high above the rulers of this age. So rise up, I say, and take your place. I've made you the head and not the tail. Resist the enemy and he will flee. Mm-hmm. Care not what man would say. Press on to the high calling in Christ Jesus. Many, now I share this because I know I've heard it with my ears as I've traveled to Florida or different places where people come from. Many have called this region foolish. Many have said they're of the devil. Remember, they said the same thing about me. Care not what man would say about you. Know that I'm with you, and I will move my victorious right hand for you. Cry out, cry out. Your cry reaches to the heavens. It is tearing a hole in the heavenlies for the next generation to enter my glory. Stay close to me. Stay close in my presence, and I will manifest myself to you, and I will show you great and mighty things you know not of. The world is watching you, Northwest. Do not back off or slack off from what you have been pressing into. This is so valuable and so important. It's what's coming forth, and it's been prophesied even. The seeds of the Northwest are going around the world. Mm-hmm. So you will see the harvest. You will see the heavens rent. I will pour out upon you my former and latter rain together. This anointing will continue to go around the world. And do not grow weary, O sons of God. For in due season you shall reap the reward.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
That's an excellent word.
Awesome.
And that's what God is doing in the church. Mm-hmm. He's raising us up to begin to have an understanding of who the bride is.
Amen.
She's connected right to heaven. Jesus is the head. So if we have the mind of Christ and we're raised with him and seated with him, then we need to have a heavenly perspective towards the earth, not an earthly perspective, so that we think according to the kingdom, and we become a victorious church with a victorious eschatology, and that causes us. I think when you look from heaven down, you see the harvest, but when you have an earthly perspective, you see the problems, and then you look for the rapture, and you have a rapture mentality rather than a harvest theology. And that's what God is birthing in the bride. He's changing the bride to where she's no longer tied to all the things that the enemy has brought that has distracted us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, to where we rise above that. You know, you said he's causing the bride to arise and shine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you become the light.
Amen.
He is the light, and
Amen.
When he's in you,
Amen.
You become the light, and the light overcomes darkness, because darkness can't exist in the light.
Mm-hmm.
So that shining is just getting connected with the King, with a kingdom understanding of who God is and what he's called the bride to be in this hour.
Amen.
And we're moving into that powerfully.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah. Knowing who we are in Christ. You know, we have the healing rooms, all of us and all the healing rooms all over have the prayer clause. And the anointing that's transferable into that. And the Word of God says that when those claws came, sicknesses, people were healed and demons fleed. And I thought, how much more us? We are the temple of the Most High God with the Holy Spirit in us. When we start to know who you are in Christ, and when you walk into a room, demons will be fleeing, and people should get healed.
Yeah.
And John G. Lake, he'd see those diseases die right in the front of, right under the microscope, you know?
Yeah, right.
And how many like to get that, not an arrogant, but a Holy Ghost, Holy God, Sons of God, manifest attitude of touch me and you die.
Sure.
And what you've talked before about, not about healing, but walking in divine health.
Yes.
And to start to see the dawning of the miraculous.
Yes.
It's the end times. It's time. The greater things in the world for right now.
Well, the Bible talks about the armor of light. Mm-hmm. So as he's in us, we're illuminated. And that's the light extinguishes darkness. Mm-hmm. So the darts from the enemy's camp, those are the things of the darkness that come, you know, which is, you know, poverty, sickness, depression, oppression, all these things. Well, light dispels darkness. So it's So the light that God gives us is that armor that those darts can't exist in, because light overcomes darkness.
Sweet, yeah.
And it simply causes them to be extinguished in midair, and then they can't touch you. So the more we are lit by God, the greater ability we have in and of ourselves to overcome everything the enemy brings against us. You know, rather than be overcome by our enemy, deliverance is really being overcome by God, you know, and to where that light is in the believer. So tell us about some of the things that are happening in the healing rooms in Honolulu.
Oh, boy. Well, we have started ACTS on Friday nights, and so it's just opening to the body of Christ for anybody to come, and just continuing. We have our television show every Saturday. And
that's on TBN?
Yeah. No, it's not on. We do host TBN once in a while.
Okay.
But, and it's really, we're good friends with them. And so if special guests come or people know, they always want to know, like, who's coming.
Okay.
And just continuing training and encouraging and building up the body of Christ, and just for other people to know that they can do it also.
Now, if somebody's watching a program and they have a friend in Hawaii on Oahu that wants to, they know that they're interested in healing, or one that they want to come get prayer or get equipped, how would they get a hold of you? Where would they go?
Well, right now it's Friday nights at the Vineyard. We're at 935 Dillingham every single Friday night at 7 o'clock, and we're there. And then we still, you could call us at the office, you can email us, it's Healing Rooms Hon, H-O-N, at AOL. And then there's a website, www.healingroomshawaii.com. Mm-hmm. People can go and get information there.
Great.
And it'd be awesome if you're here, you want to be able to come to the conference, to have people come and to see Cal and the team. And
yeah, so, because that conference starts on
March 1st, 2nd, and 3rd.
March 1st, 2nd, 3rd of 2007.
Yeah, which is not too short. Just a few weeks ago.
Yeah, we got to say that so that the viewer, you know,
I know dates sometimes are.
But you know, it's always enjoyable to go there. I just I love the spirit in the people. You know, and it's just such an awesome.
The people are so generous, and one of the things that really touched John and our heart was when we'd get done doing the training. Or, you know, people know that we've left, our kids are here and our grandkids and all you guys are here, and, you know, 20 years up north. And people will start to cry at the end of training.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for leaving your family. And I've never in my whole life been somewhere where people cry because just bringing the message.
Yes.
You know, and as we're watching what's happening in the world now, Cal, I really just sense how God really did send you to prepare the way. And you always say that, get ready, get ready, get ready. But, oh man, you have prepared the body to get ready for these end times.
Yes, because it's not going to get any easier, is it?
Yeah.
You know, the world's, man doesn't have the answer unless they have Jesus. He is the only answer. And so the tribulation in the world is just going to accelerate as we go farther and farther into being in that throne room in the wedding chapel where the bride of Christ is prepared for the wedding. So we're looking for the wedding, but we're not waiting for the wedding.
Right.
You know, we're doing the work.
Yeah.
That's what's key.
Occupying.
Is that, because when Jesus said occupy, he wasn't talking about the pew, was he?
No.
He was talking about the city. And that's what I love about healing rooms is you equip an army that have a vision. And they won't perish as long as they have that vision. And that vision needs to be for a city to take it for Christ.
Yeah. And all it takes is a person. I mean, one person. We had a gal call us. She is so excited. She was just, they'd been with us for a little while. And I was sharing about John G. Lake and the reefs. Well, she calls up later and she goes, oh, I know a pastor. Are there healing rooms in China? She said, I know a pastor who was in San Francisco. He's in Hawaii now and has a Christian bookstore or something in China. And she said, I'm going to talk to him, and I'm going to bring him to the conference. And I'm like, it just starts to happen.
It's
and I'm going, okay, let's go.
I know. You know? It's so exciting because you have somebody who comes to you, and you don't have a clue what God's about to
do.
Because that person is just coming for prayer, but they get a vision and they know where to take that vision.
Yeah.
You know? And
it's
just causing things to get birth all over the world.
Right.
All the time, you know.
The sick are getting healed and people are getting launched into their destinies, and and then they're reaching, you know, thousands and thousands of people. It's just amazing that we've gone from this one healing room to well over 500 healing rooms in just a few short years, you know, and the explosion that is taking place in all these nations that we have. I mean, really, in the nations, it's exploding. But for you in Hawaii, that's like another nation too. I mean, God really had to give you a heart for the people and the culture, because it was so foreign to us here in the States, right?
Every nation is in Hawaii.
Right.
Yeah.
There's when we have meetings or people come to the rooms, there's Chinese, there's Filipino, there's Korean, there's Hawaiian, there's Samoan, there's every nation. There's Germany. I mean, it is, you're listening to other languages all the time. We go into the healing rooms and people bring their friends and we have interpreters going, Koreans speaking and praying and it's just awesome.
Yes.
It really is awesome.
That is so good.
Yeah, and all those people that live there that get involved in the healing rooms, they have relatives that are in their homeland that seed is going into. And
we're going to see more of that.
It's like a hub.
And if they're interested, they can contact us here at the International Office.
Amen. And Elaine, boy, she does a terrific job handling 500 people, you know, nations and people and situations with such love and grace.
Thank you.
We're glad you're here for us.
She does an excellent job connecting with all the leadership around the world. That's a big job.
And she does too, and remember everything.
Yeah, because we have now, we have how many people working in the International Association offices here?
About six.
Because we have an accounting person in that office as well. So
I think he's prophesying it's going to be the largest department in the international office. So it's like, Lord, send help.
Well, because we'll go to 1,000 healing rooms and then 2,000, you know. But, if you do want to get a hold of us, you can contact us at healingrooms.com or healing@healingrooms.com, which is the website. And you can also email birthing@healingrooms.com
to international.
Get connected into the International Association and start that work in your community, in your city. You know, Jesus is no respecter of persons, but he's also no respecter of cities. What he does in Hawaii, he will do in China, he will do in South America, any nation around the world. So so get a hold of us so that you can play a part in bringing healing to your city. And you can do it because it's what Jesus wants to do through you. Okay, God bless you, and thank you for watching the program.
This man named Jesus called me out. If you think your little problem is too big for him to solve.